Mention great music of the church and complicated oratorios of harmonious choruses or angelic descants might come to mind. How unusual it is, then, that one of the most famous and most loved hymns would consist of only five notes. That, however, is the case with When I Survey the Wondrous Cross. When Lowell Mason, an important American musician of the 19th century, set Isaac Watts's beautiful verse to music, he used an ancient Gregorian chant dating from the 6th century, arranging it to a simple yet haunting melody. But no hymn, however lovely, can stand on music alone, and it is the wedding of words and melody that have made this communion hymn so popular. The author, Isaac Watts, was the eldest of nine children born to a well-educated deacon in the Congregational Church of Southampton, England, in 1674. As a child, Watts had an insatiable and inquiring mind. At the age of 4, he began to study Latin. When he was 9, he took up Greek. By the age of 11, he had added French, and when he was 13, he decided to conquer Hebrew. He was a poet from the time he could string words together, and as he matured, began to converse in rhyme. His father, frustrated by what he considered an irritating and precocious habit, threatened to spank Isaac if he persisted. Isaac responded with a poetic retort, and Reverend Watts delivered the promised spanking. A tearful but impressionable Isaac was said to have vowed, "O Father, do some pity take, and I will no more verses make." Fortunately for those of us who enjoy great hymns, Isaac Watts did not keep his word. At the age of 15, after sitting through a lengthy period of what he considered to be a dull and uninspired congregational singing, he complained to his father, "The singing of God's praise is the part of worship highest or nighest heaven. The singing of God's praise is the part of worship nighest heaven, and its performance among us is the worst on earth." At that time the practice was for the leader of the congregation to read a psalm line by line. The congregation would then repeat each line in a sing-song fashion. Responding to young Isaac's complaints, his father challenged him to write something better. And so it was that Isaac Watts composed his first hymn. I'm going to interject here with the notion of how much better can you get than the psalms. But I know what he's talking about, repeated readings, you know. Nothing quite so boring, you know, as presenting God's word in that way. But nonetheless, you can't get better than God's word. The following week, he presented his new hymn to the congregation, and it was met with great enthusiasm. Isaac had found a welcome and appreciative audience for his poetry and continued to compose a hymn each week for the next 2 years. Many of his hymns used favorite psalms in new poetical settings. Two of these still enjoyed today are Jesus Shall Reign. Jesus shall reign where the sun doth his successive journey run. His kingdom spread from shore to shore, till earth shall reign. And God, God, our help in ages past, which doesn't come to mind at the moment. But the creative mind of Isaac Watts was not content to restate psalms. As he grew older, I wish it would have been. You know, it makes you wonder if God put it in his heart and he didn't do it, but that'd be quite a shame. As he grew older, he ventured into a new area of hymn writing by composing hymns that spoke of personal feelings and emotional responses to the facts and doctrines of the Bible. When I Survey the Wondrous Cross, written in 1707, was one of the hymns that became very controversial for this reason. It was as if Watts pictured himself at the foot of the cross with Mary and John gazing in wonder at the crucified Christ. And I want to also interject that the song came to mind, and wow, it was 30 years ago when I was last in Israel and stood at the foot of Calvary, and the song came to mind, and I sang it there between the Lord and I. Public criticism of this type of hymn and the stigma of being branded a radical churchman didn't seem to bother Watts, nor did it slow his production of beautiful and meaningful hymns. In all, he composed over 600 hymns and earned himself the title of the Father of English Hymnody. It was not a title Watts sought, but one suspects he would not have been displeased by it, especially given his response when asked why he devoted himself so tirelessly to composing of hymns. He said, "It was not my design to exalt myself to the rank and glory of poets, but I was ambitious to be a servant to the churches and a helper to the joy of the meanest Christian. A helper to the joy of the meanest Christian." Isaac Watts achieved his life's goal. The hundreds of Christian hymns he composed have indeed served the churches around the world and brought joy to many a believer. When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, my richest gain I count but loss, and pour contempt on all my pride. Forbid it, Lord, that I should boast, save in the death of Christ, my God. All the vain things that charm me most, I sacrifice them to His blood. See from His head, His hands, His feet, sorrow and love flow mingled down. Did e'er such love and sorrow meet, or thorns compose so rich a crown? Were the whole realm of nature mine, that were a present far too small, love so amazing, so divine, demands my soul, my life, my all.